And here we are as Kyle Katarn once more. Now, a few things I should go over. First of all, you may notice that the GUI, the HUD, is flickering. Now, I don't see that as I'm playing, but I know that my recording software does that. It may even cause the right bottom HUD display, the one that shows my ammo, to disappear. It may make it disappear. If it does, I apologize. There's nothing I can do for that. And any other visual problems like that, not much I can do. Hopefully they won't be too bad. Also, as I'm playing right now, there is no music in the game. The music doesn't really work correctly for this. Not on Windows 7 anyway. So I'm going to be adding it in post, and hopefully you'll hear it looping just fine. But I don't. Also, right here, we've got Kyle's lightsaber. It's orange, orangish yellow. You may think that's odd, since we had a green one when I did my Let's Play. But if we were on the light side, we would have. After we finished.
Imperial troops have entered the base. Repeat, Imperial troops have entered the base.
I want to explain this without distraction, so I'm gonna try to explain this before I go too far. Now, in the original game, when you play to the point where. There we go. Sorry, guys. When you play to the point where you get off that falling spacecraft, if you're on the light side, Kyle crashes Jada's. Is her name Jada? Well, anyway, he crashes his female friend's ship, and he's found unconscious by the Dark Jedi, and they smash his lightsaber, and they'd be about to execute him, except Yen, that very first Jedi you fight, sacrifices himself by blocking the attempt to kill Kyle, and then we take Yen's lightsaber, and that's this one, the orangish yellow lightsaber. So that's why we've got this color of lightsaber. I don't know why Kyle is wearing black leather though. That's kind of strange. Because he is supposed to be a good guy here, and yet he's dressed like a Dark Jedi. It's weird. Also, apparently, I discussed a little bit how these guys just respond indefinitely, apparently. I discussed in the first game how it's... Well, in Jedi Knight, that is. How it's a little strange, I think, that... Come on, guy, you better get inside. Oh, that one rebel's getting closed out. He doesn't care, though, apparently. Oh. Lame. Whatever. I don't really care. Can I open this one? Nope. How'd you guys get in here? What the hell? Okay. We got an A-Wing just dropped on him and exploded. God damn it, what was I talking about? I don't even remember now. I apologize. Oh well. I'll probably recall at some point. Now, something that's kind of strange about this game that I didn't really notice in Jedi Knight is, as you get further away, notice that these stormtroopers change. Up close, they look not too bad, all things considered. But as you back away, their model snaps to a lower res version. First it's just the torso, then it's the rest of the body, and you get far enough away they just become like basically a number of planes that just have textures on them. See, right now they're hardly even three-dimensional at this point from this distance. And look at the trooper there, the rebel trooper, he kind of does the same thing. I didn't notice that in Star Wars Jedi Knight. I guess it's a good idea in theory because it lets you have more models on screen at once without causing any trouble for the engine. But I don't know. I wish I could turn it off, but I don't know of any way to do that. Oh, I cut his arm off. First try. Nice. Ooh, I better watch my ass. I'm getting myself killed. Ah. Okay. Time to abuse quick saves, just like last time. Whoa, whoa, whoa. What? Where'd they come from? How'd they get up there on the roof? Whatever. I think I need to go this way. Open. Whoa. Who's shooting? Who's shooting at me? What the hell? Yeah, look, now we've got, like, gray hair, so clearly this is quite some time later. Oh, wrong direction. Should have been paying a little more attention to my fighting. Better get the hell out of here. Whoa! Come on, damn it. Try me, bro. I still got great deflection skills, thankfully. Oh, I remember now. I was talking about how
we need your help back in ops. They've got us pinned down.
In ops, where's that? I don't know. Maybe I need to go back to that one place. I'll give it a shot. I remember discussing in Star Wars Jedi Knight how it's interesting that everyone is called Dark Jedi. The bad guys were the Dark Jedi. But as of the prequel trilogy, suddenly there aren't Dark Jedi, they're all Sith. God damn it. How are they shooting right through my shields like that? Maybe they always did, I don't know. Pricks. I was gonna come up here and check out what we got, because I didn't look up here. Maybe I got some health or something, at the very least. Oh, okay, this is where I was. Any health? It'd make it worthwhile. Oh, these things. Ugh. Whatever. Back to. I don't remember where my back to quick key was. Oh well, I'll find out eventually. Anyway, but in this game, it mentions the Sith, and this came out before the prequel trilogy began. So I think that episode 1 came out in, what, like 1999? Well, this game's from 1998. So either George Lucas told them about this new thing called the Sith he was working on, or it was always there, and they just didn't really use it until this point. I don't actually recall at what point the Sith are mentioned in the original trilogy or not mentioned or anything like that. Stop it. Oh, lame. Where am I? Oh, back here? Okay. So maybe it was mentioned and intended all along, but they just decided to use Dark Jedi? I don't know. Again, I still wish that they'd used Dark Jedi more and not always rely on everything being Sith. I wish the Sith would just be like extra... Whoa. It'd just be extra powerful, extra evil Dark Jedi. Or like a race of aliens that just tended towards being Dark Jedi. But they weren't necessarily... Not necessarily all Dark Jedi were Sith. I wish it'd be that way. Because in the prequels, like in episode 1... Crap. I'll be right back. And I'm back. I guess I just don't want to be backed on me, though. Shucks. Alright. For the prequel trilogy, Yoda says, only two there are, no more, no less, in regards to the Sith. As if they just can't stand to work together or something. Because they're always struggling to overcome each other, and they always fight all the time. While Jarek seemed to have done just fine having a number of Dark Jedi at his back. He didn't seem to have any problem there. So, it's as if the Dark Jedi just... Oh, god damn it. I mean to kill that guy. You heard that kind of sound when I killed that guy? That's the sound of my dark side points going up. I'm not sure exactly what would happen if I'd push up a lot of dark side points. It really doesn't matter that much because you only play Kyle for a few levels in this game. Most of it's playing his apprentice. Oh, huh. Were these guys in the previous game? I think maybe they were briefly, but not that much. Well, maybe I should have been playing this on easy like I did the last game. These guys are kind of kicking my ass. Oh, well. I'll manage somehow. With quick saves and perseverance, I'll get through. Hopefully without it being too boring to watch. Come at me, bro. Yeah. There we go. We're finally not doing too bad at this point. Thank God for shields and health sitting around all over the place. This isn't the way, though? Huh. Apparently not. Alright. Not sure where I'm going. Tell me where I'm going, bro. Ugh. Thought this is the way. Oh, I got a key, didn't I? That's right. That's what I wanted. There we are. Okay. Now we got some progress. Ooh. Oh, that's not what we wanted. We've also got a number of force powers, although they're not very significant. We don't have any big light side force powers, unfortunately. Which is kind of ridiculous, because we wouldn't have been able to beat Jerick if we didn't have some of those force powers. So like we got, what's this? We got force jump, force run, force seeing. Okay. And force pull, and that's it. That sucks. And I think force pull is a little less useful in this game than it was in the previous game. I'm pretty sure in the previous game, if you did force pull on someone, they'd lose their weapons if you just run around like idiots and do nothing. While here, if you force pull their weapons away, they'll come up and punch you instead. And just like with the beginning of Star Wars Jedi Knight, enemies that punch are actually more dangerous than enemies with guns, because they'll punch right through your shields. And that sucks. Because your life is a lot more precious than your shields. Well, they just blow this tunnel out just like that? You guys should have secured your base a bit better. No wonder you're getting your asses handed to you. Ooh, nice. Come on. Lightsaber's a little slow there. Whoa. God damn it. There. Don't do that again, random explosion. Oh. Oh well. I was gonna kind of do that anyway. The force jump. Come on.